What's up, Assassins? Welcome to the newest series, Breaking Down in Budget, where we try to build a quality sound studio under a certain price point. And today, we're going to do that with $2,000. Here's a couple things that we have to forego if we're trying to build it under $2,000, because $2,000 is not a lot of money when it comes to building a studio. One of the things are acoustics. Acoustics plays a major part, but if you spend all your money on acoustics, then you have nothing else. I'm going to show you how to get around that for the time being, but understand acoustics are the most important thing you can have in your studio. Another thing that we won't be discussing in this video is a desk. If you don't have a desk, then look in the description below, because next week I'll be dropping a video on how to build a studio under $5,000 and a desk will be included. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started. Let's dive right in. Okay, so let's start with interfaces. Sitting at the price range at $299, I chose the Universal Audio Volt 276. Now, with the UA Volt, you get two outputs, two mic inputs, a headphone output, and a direct monitoring button. Now, let me tell you, if you don't know what a direct monitoring button is, you ever be recording and you notice that you're like, okay, what? You're rapping or you're singing and you have a little bit of latency, not delay, but latency, where you speak into the microphone and then a couple seconds later you hear your voice. Maybe it could be a millisecond later, 2 milliseconds later, and it really throws you off. Well, with direct monitoring, it really cuts that all out. It's zero latency, and Universal Audio decided to include that as a button. Whereas most other audio interfaces, you have to do that via the app if it offers that. If it doesn't offer that, then you gotta spend more money to get better hardware to get a better zero latency sound. And that's what we're trying to avoid. So kudos to Universal Audio for that. Here are the caveats with it. If you're familiar with Universal Audio, then you know that Universal Audio is known for their plugins. Amazing top of the line plugins. Some of the best plugins in the world. And you need a host to host out plugins. Well, here's the bad news. The Volt coming in at this low price point, they had to sacrifice the DSP, which means that you cannot run your UAD plugins on the Volt. It is not your entryway in. You will have to have a satellite, or you might have to upgrade to another interface. But because we're trying to build a studio under $2,000, a higher interface in Universal Audio is out the question. You may or may not use Universal Audio plugins. If you do, then you probably already have something to host it. If you do not and you want to use it, you will need a satellite. If you don't care about running the UA plugins, but you want the UA sound, then the Volt is just for you. It's a low entry cost that will give you the classic analog sound. Now, I also included another audio interface. And it's one of my personal favorites. I really love Audient. So I included the Audient ID14. Now with the Audient ID14, it is powered by the USB-C, which means it's gonna be moving a lot faster and a lot stronger. It also comes with two mic inputs and four outputs, two headphone slots and an instrument slot. And what I love about Audient as well is that you can do direct monitoring. But, like I said earlier, you have to do it through the app, which is very simple. Once you figure it out, it takes a little bit of working on it. If you hit me in the comments and you really need help, then we could probably set something up. Now, these are my choices for audio interfaces. Your choices may be something different, but again, I'm just wanting to give my input on things that I love and companies that I've used in the past or currently use. Okay, next, we got microphones. Now, I chose an AKG C214. I love this microphone. I've gotten to use this microphone on multiple R&B singers, and I really, in my heart, I feel like this is a great microphone for singers. The way it just hits, and it's so nice, beautiful, and bright. It sits at $350. It's right in the budget. All these microphones, we will be totally up at the end. So this sits at $350. This is a great microphone for singers in my own opinion. I didn't like it too much for rappers. I felt like they would be better for something else. But if you are a singer or you only service singers, this microphone is for you. Next up, we got the Audio-Technica AT4040. Now you got the Audio-Technica sitting at $300. It's $50 less than the C214, and it's great for all around. But again, it's all about what you're trying to get. Don't get the cheapest mic because it's cheaper. Get the mic that suits your needs. Now, I've used this microphone on rappers and I use it on singers. Now, I've gotten a great sound out of both. If you only service one side more than the other, then of course you might want to go more towards a microphone that is better suited for that audience. Next up, we got the SE Electronics SE2200. Now, here's the thing. I had that microphone for years. This was my first beginner microphone. I got it because Amy Winehouse said she loved it. And I was like, you know what? I really want to record singers, so I really want to get that microphone. And true, it really, really worked well with singers, but it was very, very harsh when it got loud and it got a little bit distorted. So I didn't like it as much, and my acoustic game isn't like it is now. Now, if you're thinking, should you get the C214 or should you get the 2200? I'm going to tell you get the 214 because it's more geared to the singer and it sounds a lot better. Now you got the SE Electronics microphone sitting at $290. It's on sale right now. Normal price is $350, so get it while it's hot if you choose that you want this microphone. Now, the next microphone we have is the Warm Audio WA47 Junior. That microphone currently sits at $250. It is a powerhouse. Now, I haven't heard this in person, just being honest, but I love Warm Audio's microphones. And I will add that in there because I just know how much pride they take in their work and how much it sounds amazing. So that microphone sits at $250. And yes, it is cheaper. Again, it's cheaper, but this is great for pop singers. I've heard it on multiple pop records and it sounds great for pop and R&B singers. I didn't hear too much about rappers on there, so I don't want to tell you to get it if you're a rapper because I don't want to mess you up. Next up, we got the SM7B. You most likely seen this microphone on shows like The Breakfast Club or Hot 97 and so forth, but did you know that this microphone is the same microphone that recorded Michael Jackson's Thriller? Now, this microphone sits at $350 as well. It's a great microphone. This is for a rapper or a singer. If you have a low tone, like a Rick Ross type of voice, it sounds great. It spreads around, you can feel it and everything. Or if you have a high voice, a very, very high voice, it sounds amazing. You can go back and listen to Thriller if you need an example. Hey, if you do part-time singing, part-time podcasting, well, this microphone is right there for you. Or if you're an engineer who wants to add this to their collection, then you can have this microphone if you have clients who are podcasters and for singers as well. Now, if you're a rapper, you got a low voice, this works for you as well. I'm talking about the gritty, the low voice, the Rick Ross type of voice, Slim Thug, if you know who Slim Thug is. So yeah, I feel like these microphones will be great for you. Now I got one more microphone I want to share with you before we go, and that is a Lewitt 440. Now again, I haven't heard this microphone in person, but it has great reviews. Now, what I hear from this microphone is very, very warm. It's very warm. It gives you the nice analog sound. With the rappers, it sounds great if you have a mid-tone voice. I think this microphone will be great. This microphone sits at $269. So if this microphone is for you and you're very mid-rangey, or your client that you're working with is very mid-rangey, you might want to go ahead and grab this microphone. This is for rappers or singers. Next up, we got headphones. Depending on the type of person you are, you might like it really loud or really low. So I tried to get an all-around headphone. I chose the Sennheiser 280 HD Pro. Those sit at $99. In this budget video, you're gonna get two pairs. One for you, one for your client. I really like these headphones because you can turn them all the way up, but still likes to feel the 808 and the snares and the vocals all sitting in your face and the kicks and whatnot. This is a great headphones for you. If that is not for you and you're only recording for yourself, then I probably would tell you to get the DT770s made by Behringer. I started off with these Behringer headphones and I like to hear my bass. If you don't want to hear the 808, you want to hear your vocals and you want to hear like the mids and up and don't really care about the low, you might want to go with the DT770s. But again, because of the price range we're trying to stay within, you can only afford one. Next up, we got speakers. Now, I love talking about speakers. After you get the interface and you get the microphone, you gotta have something to listen out of. For me, in my opinion, I think Atom Audio makes some of the best speakers in the world. So I'm gonna recommend the T5V by Atom Audio. They sit in about $400 for the pair, but here's the thing. You can't turn them up super loud because they get very distorted. That is the only caveat with it, but they sound amazing. They sound really, really great. I've had Atom Audio speakers throughout my whole career. I started with the A3Xs, then I moved to the A5Xs. Next, I'm gonna get the A7Xs. I also have a pair of the T5V speakers. You can't crank them too hard because they get really distorted, but for the loudness that you can get them up to, it sounds great, pure, crispy, clear, exactly what you're probably looking for, exactly what I'm looking for. So if you don't want clear, if you don't want crispy, then I don't know what to tell you. Next, I want to talk about cables. Cables are so important when you put your studio together because that's how you can connect everything. Now, there's two companies that I want to mention. There's Pighog and there's Hosa. Here's the thing about the two. Hosa has been around a lot longer and they are really, really known to be very durable. They're durable and they're inexpensive. Now, with Pighog, they have a lifetime warranty. I really like them. I have their cables as well. Something about their cables I really love about their sound. And they have a lifetime warranty. Did I mention that? So take that into account. You don't want to cheap out on the cables and get $1,000 equipment and get $5 cables. We want to get quality cables. Next up, we're going to talk about pop filters. Now, there's different types of pop filters. Now you have your mesh pop filters and you have your metal pop filters. And then you have what's called combined, where you get the double layer, where you get the mesh and you get the metal. Now, you're probably wondering what's the difference. Here's the downside to having a mesh pop filter. They remove the high frequencies. Sometimes I record without any pop filter, just so I can hear the difference, because sometimes my mind will play tricks on me. Now, the thing with the metal pop filters is, you don't have to worry about the highs with the metal. What you do have to worry about is the metallic whistling. I've recorded songs and I didn't notice the whistling until after it was time to mix it. So, what can you do? Well, you can get the dual layer. It sounds great and it deals with those problems that I said were the cons of both, but also integrates the cons of both. So it's like a catch 22. It works great, but you also gotta still pay attention to both of those things now. But I did include that in there for a price of $25. Now we talked about acoustic treatment. If you don't have it, what are things you can do to make up for it? Well, you can't do much, honestly. And I'm not talking about putting a little bit of foam or some egg cartons here and there, like real acoustic panels, rock soil and whatnot. Like something that you see over here that's supposed to be covered up, but it's not really covered up. So I'm gonna get to that at some point. Now, because we have such a little budget, I'm gonna recommend the Chaotica Eyeball. I really love the Chaotica Eyeball. I would recommend this if you have acoustic treatment. I've seen the Chaotica Eyeball be recorded outside and inside a fully treated studio and give you a very, very clean sound. And that's exactly what we're going for. We're going for quality, right? So I would definitely recommend the Chaotica Eyeball. Right now it sits at $200. Let's move on. Here's where things get a little bit tricky. I put $400 for a laptop. If you already have a laptop, you can use that $400 and upgrade everything I was just talking about in this video. Or get some acoustic. Get some acoustics. Probably just take the $400 and get some acoustics. So at $400, you can get a pretty decent PC or a decent MacBook. I am PC based on mostly everything that I do. I own a Mac, but I don't use it as much. I use everything when it comes to video editing, music production. I use everything on my PC. And my PC, I upgraded it. So I found my PC, it's an i7, and I upgraded it 16 gigs of RAM for $300. The RAM costs $100, so that's why I said $400. But That thing is a monster. It's a monster. I haven't had any issues with it. Now, my desktop, that costs more money, and it's a bigger monster. But because we're trying to keep within the confines of this $400, you can go on eBay and find a true monster, just like I did. I want to give you a couple of things to look for when you are looking for a laptop. One of them is your CPU. I recommend an i3 or i5 or i7, i9. You know, you get the drift. You want something there and going up. i3 being the lowest you want to go, because when you open up your programs, you want your programs to be moving smoothly. The higher up you can go, the more smoother it will be. Now, let's talk about RAM. RAM, I honestly would recommend no less than 8 gigs of RAM. If you're using things like Pro Tools or Fruity Loops, they require 4. Now, 4 is great, but you also have to take into account that your computer is also using that RAM too, so you're probably left with 2. And you don't want to be left with 2, and you got a session that might end up being 30 or 40 tracks, because your computer won't be able to handle it, and then you'll have to apologize, give refunds, and lose out on your reputation. And I'm talking from experience. So you don't want that to happen. So just keep those things in mind. If you have any questions, feel free to email me, you know, links down below. So get at me if you need me. And last but not least, I don't hear a lot of people talk about this, so I'm glad to bring it to you. You want to get these things called ISO acoustics. These will make the world of difference on your speakers. These ISO acoustics are built to take off the pressure of your speaker to give you a more true sound. Monitor stands, you still have your bottom touching it, so you might have bass buildup and you're probably getting the wrong representation. With the ISO acoustics, you can put those on your monitor stand and get a better representation. You can maneuver them when you get them, you can make them go up a little higher, a little bit lower, you can have them angle forward, angle backward, just so everything hits you perfectly. That wraps up this video. As you can see, it hits just around 1995-ish. That's without tax. So I just want you to take these things in consideration. If you are shopping, this is just my opinion. I've been doing this for 20 years of production, about 8 years of mixing, and about 12 years of recording. So these are just my humble opinions. Like and subscribe if you like this video. You know, I definitely want to hear something from you. Let me know down in the comments what's your takeaway and how I can better serve you and the community. All right, y'all, I'm out of here. Peace. Ninja, vanish!